Sizing your inverter is the third and final step in properly sizing an entire solar power system. Welcome back to the lab, guys. You are in the sixth video of a short little series that we put together to help you guys understand the fundamentals of solar power, what all the terms and everything means, and ultimately, at the end of the day, purchase or understand how to properly size a solar power system that properly fits your needs. At any point in this video, if you find it helpful, make sure you like it, share it with some friends, get this stuff out there, because this is a free resource. We have nothing to sell you. We just were in the same boat that you're in right now. We were trying to learn stuff and there was no understandable resources out there. Everything was going right over our heads. Getting into this video, if you have not watched the previous two, I would go back in the playlist and just check them out. Make sure you understand how to size your battery bank, and then make sure you understand how to size your solar panel array. When it comes to actually choosing the right size inverter, it's actually really simple, assuming you already did the first two steps. What you need to know is how much you're gonna be powering at one time, your average hourly load. You need to know the wattage of that. The second thing we need to know is the size of our solar panel array in watts. And the only other thing that you really need to consider is, are you running 120 volts or 240 volts? Now, something to note is that most inverters, if they don't do 240, most of the time you can pair two inverters to run 240s. And so selecting the inverter is really simple. In our examples, we need to be able to power 1700 watts at once, and we have a 2500 watt solar array. We know that most things we're gonna be powering are 120 volts. We're just doing lights and little heaters and stuff like that in the garage. Nothing crazy, but we might want 240 in the future. And so we wanna make sure that we get one that in the future could be expanded on to be able to run 240. So the first and most important number on an inverter is gonna be the output. In our case, we said we need 1700 watts of output per hour. We would recommend in that case looking for like a 3000 watt inverter. That gives us the ability to run some extra appliances, some extra lights, whatever it is that we wanna do. We have room to grow with it in the future, or just randomly plug something in that day. We're not limited to exactly what we did our math on. So our 1700 watt number that we got a couple videos ago is what we're gonna use to determine that we want about 3000 watt inverter. When it comes to the input number, that's gonna be your solar panel sizing. We determined that we want a 2500 watt solar panel array, and we actually found an inverter on EG4's website that does the 3000 watt that we need for output, and it has a 5000 watt solar input, which is ridiculously high. It's double what we need, but it's also perfect because if we ever decide to expand or add onto the system, we have so much room to grow with it. We don't need to get a new inverter. And the only exception to where these terms wouldn't really apply is if you're just trying to take solar from your roof and sell it back to the grid, which is kind of being phased out. A lot of places, especially like California, already rolled out the NEM 3.0, which is basically just saying they're not paying you for the power that you're generating anymore. They're cutting what they were paying you by more than half. So it's not really worth doing. If you're looking for an inverter for that, good luck. That's not what we're focused on here, as that's kind of just no longer an appropriate way to go about solar. We would always recommend just going off-grid or hybrid. And now that you guys understand how to do this math, you can also choose if you want to go with a traditional solar power system, like the one I have mounted on the wall behind me, or if you want to go with a portable power station system, which are growing really, really quickly in the space. They're a very popular option. And in our next video, we're going to go over the pros and cons of each, because to be honest, me and Tiny Baby have opposing views on this, and there isn't necessarily one that's better than the other, but depending on your lifestyle, one of these may fit your life better. So that's all we got for you guys in this video. If this helped you at all, please be sure to share it and help spread some knowledge about an industry that'll actually be able to help change people's lives. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.